Don't forget to check out my Patreon, where we have exclusive content for groups such as TWICE, 17, Red Velvet, Blackpink, NCT, SuperM, SHINee, ATEEZ, Stray Kids, and so much more, along with K-dramas, concerts, and other variety shows. Hey guys, Angie here. Today we have Stray Kids Maniac music video. It just came out. It's midnight. So yeah, one sec, let me get it pulled up. But yeah, it like just came out. It is exactly midnight. Good. See? 8 views. It's probably higher now, but looks like the teasers actually kind of fit in with the music video. Yeah, I didn't get to react to this. I guess we should do it, but okay. My previous, like, my going into it type vibes is I instinctively think I may not like it as much as Thunderous or God's Menu, but I think I like it more than Backdoor. Let's see. Perfect intro, remember? Oh, so the teasers were like just the first scene. I like Bangchan's outfit and look. Oh, I love that dance. Oh, falsetto, no. This scene reminds me of their doo-doo-doo performance of like Deadpool. I think it was G-Sum in there too. I'm not gonna lie, I hate the background noise. Very popular right now. Hate it. I hate it with Stray Kids. I mean, not Stray Kids. I hate it with NCT. I hate it with aespa. I hate it with NMIX. I hate that sound, and Stray Kids are doing it, so I'm like, ugh, okay. Deal with it, I guess. Like, why is every song like, let's put an annoying backtrack when everything else sounds good without it? Oh, okay, it's gone though. Oh, okay. I'm not seeing much iron. There we go. Oh, thank you. There's a sweet, oh, that's cool. There's like a sweet sounding song, and there's like a really grungy, dirty type to it. Like this part's nice and earlier. Oh, I hate it so much, that sound, but I've gotten indie into it. Oh! Felix looks so pretty. Felix said, I'm not innocent. I'm always throwing it back on TikTok. Is that someone doing that? Oh, or is it Ian? It sounds like Ian. Really, Shipman knows that. Oh, this is a different type of bridge for them. Kind of. There you go, someone.
There's something missing from the song. It's like it's missing a bit of a Stray Kids flair. You can't describe it. Okay, I feel like we are missing something. I'm trying to like... I think it's... The raps weren't hitting. I like, this is my favorite part of the song. I love the video and the choreo. It's they would like Backdoor, but I'll definitely listen to it more than Backdoor, because Backdoor, I think to this day, is my least favorite Stray Kids song. Backdoor and probably like Backdoor and I can't think of it right now, but like Backdoor is one of my least favorite Stray Kids songs ever. I can't deny, I think this is the first time I feel like Stray Kids went with the trend. Usually Stray Kids stick with their own league, and they kind of like added the trend of darkness in K-pop. I would personally say that. Then in like probably like ADs, like simultaneously, they kind of added that darkness to K-pop, which I kind of hate now, but I like ADs and Stray Kids doing it because it was already them. But now they're following that trend of like a simple song with an annoying instrumental that like NCT always have done it, but because that's kind of their sound, it always works more. Like Aespa, ITZY kind of did it. I feel like ITZY have gotten better with it though. And Mix, whatever that group's called, Kepler, like really annoying songs, and I'm gonna get so hated for that, but like I can't stand it. Like Stray Kids kind of do noise music, but they do it in a better way because it really suits the rappers that they have, because if you don't have good rappers, it doesn't sound good. And then their vocalists, there's only like two true main vocalists in their group, like, or vocalists at all really, because like Minho and Jisung sing too, but that's not really their main position. So it works good with Stray Kids. I feel like their rappers carry that sound and make it less annoying. I don't know. I don't really love it. I'm not gonna lie though. This is their best comeback? Definitely disagree. Maybe their album. I have to listen to the album. But definitely not their best song. I think it's very repetitive. And Stray Kids are never repetitive. I can't think of a song, a title track, where their song's repetitive. Because God's Menu, Thunderous, Side Effects, Miro, like they're not very repetitive. I don't know. I'm not disappointed though. It's fine. It's just I always have high expectations for them, and this one definitely fell short. I think because Thunderous was so wow, and this one's very, it's not mediocre, it's just very simple. And Stray Kids are never simple, so it's really weird to me. This feels like it should be like the subtitle track. Like, it's like the, Easy and stuff like that, the Domino. It sounds like it should be the second title track, like the sub one that they perform with the title track. Does anyone else agree? I'm probably gonna get really hated, but I love Stray Kids. They're top 10 favorite groups to me, and poster, like I love Stray Kids. Pre-ordered the albums, like I'm here for it. I just don't like the title track that much, but I'll listen to it and then tell you how I feel more when we get to the album, because I mean usually Stray Kids title tracks are some of my favorites, so I think that's why I'm a little like about it, because it definitely fell short to me. But I didn't like Backdoor either, so you know, this is gonna be some misses. I don't like everyone's title tracks, but Stray Kids usually I like them. Yeah, not much to say. The video was cool. Once again though, the video didn't really, like, why is it their like trailers are better than their music videos? It's really interesting. Like, the storyline's better in the trailers. Interesting. But it was really cool. It looked great. Hyunjin was cool. I like the choreo. The choreo is fun. I think the thing is with Thunderous, I loved watching. I looked forward to the performances, and I'm not really looking forward to seeing the live performance of Maniac because the song's eh. But I'll probably do it anyways.
So it's been like, let's say, 2 hours. Took a shower, listened to the song a few more times, and I can conclude I dislike the song more as I listen to it, which I think is very much the effect of like how I felt with Sticker by NCT, where I thought it was a little like it was not my favorite the first time, and then when I heard it more, it became more annoying. And I will say I'm okay with that personally, but I know people are gonna like hate that I don't like it because people think you need to like everything from your favorite artist. I'm under the impression it's fine to dislike something your favorite artist does. I want to come in here and say it so you can I can explain more because as I listen to it more, I know what I hate about it. First, it's the thing I said in the video where it's like the beat is really annoying. And the beat, it's like during Changbin's rap and I think Jisung's rap the second time. Like it's in the verse where the rappers go. And I said in the video like that it felt empty or like it felt not Stray Kids. And I think it's because usually what happens in a Stray Kids song is the rap kind of is the when the rap comes in, that's like the focus. And which is good because they have good rappers. So if you have good rappers, focus on them. But it's hard to focus on the rap because the beat is just in your ear. And to me, it sounds like nails on a chalkboard. I really hate the beat. I was in the shower and I changed the song because I was like, I really hate the beat. I hate it so much. And it's not a bad beat. I just hate it. Like, it's just me. I just hate it. I went on Twitter to see if anyone else dislikes the song. Hard to see, can't tell. And so the part I liked about the song was the maniac part, but it got repetitive. Like I said in the, I think I said in the video, it's kind of redundant. I don't know if I said that, but like I felt that in the first listen too. It's a little repetitive, a little boring. I think they're hammering the maniac part in too much. I feel like they could have done more with the chorus. I'm not sure what the song is supposed to feel like. Like, I don't know. It feels okay. It feels like three different songs because the bridge was really good, but the bridge didn't fit, which is why it felt like an aespa song, or it felt like a NMIX song, or it felt like the songs that are really trendy right now. The let's put three different songs in one song. The thing is, Stray Kids definitely did it better. It feels more cohesive, but it doesn't make me like it anymore. It just sounds like a better version of like all the songs that are out right now, like a better rendition. So it's definitely not as bad as Next Level or whatever the heck NMIX's song is called. I really hate those songs, and it's nothing against NMIX or aespa. It's not their fault they got trashy songs. Like, or like they're not trashy. I just don't like them. No hate to aespa, no hate to NMIX. They got what they got. They have to deal with it because they are a girl group who do not get to produce their songs. Stray Kids are following that trend but doing it way better, but I still don't like it that much more. It's just like I respect it more because I know they did it. But yeah, I don't like it. It's not going in the playlist. I like the bridge and I like the maniac part. I just don't like how repetitive it is, and I like the rap part, but I don't like the beat behind it. So, but yeah, I just want to explain more because I did get to kind of sit with the song a bit more, and I sadly like it less, but that's totally fine. They have 80 million songs, and hopefully the album's better. So yeah.
But we'll discuss more when we get to the album, because the B-sides are where they're at for me. It's the more important part. But yeah, I'll see you guys in the album reaction. Don't hate me stays, just my opinion. Bye.
Three, four, five, two, two, three, four, five, three, two, three, four.